Welcome everyone to day number 3 of Retro Gaming Month. And in this episode, I decided to kick it back even further. And I am playing my Atari, which actually it's not even my Atari, it's my mom's Atari. Back whenever she actually played games. I know it's weird to think that your parents played games back in the day, whenever they were only dots. As you can see right here, 1981, Atari Incorporated. And I'm going to be playing Asteroids. Alright, let's start this thing. Arr, die, orange rocks! I was holding down. Okay, really? This is such a wonderful game to, you know, kind of kill you instantly like that. There we go. And you will be hearing the clickings of the controller itself because, well, yeah, this is Atari. This has the worst joystick ever created. I'm not even sure which version of Atari this is. I think this is the 2600, although I could be very, very wrong on that. It's kind of lost some of the printing on it. And I'm actually very, very shocked I got this to work. So, hopefully... Whoa, okay. Don't fly towards blue rocks, everybody. That's a bad idea. Wow, hyperdrive is like the worst thing you could ever do. It's just whenever you hit down, you kind of teleport. And you see that? It almost killed me. So I guess if you're in a pinch, you could chance it, but that's about it. So yeah, I'm deciding to take it kind of easy today also, because due to allergies or like sinus drainage or whatever, my god, I blew up and killed off the space rock. But I don't know what it is about my throat, but it kind of dries out very quickly, so... Yeah, that kind of sucks. Hopefully I'll be able to, you know, still do good commentary and whatnot. Or, you know, with voice clarity, I should say. Okay, I meant to press down and I pressed up instead on this control joystick. Listen to that click. That is so freaking loud for a click. There's no way to cover that up. Okay, How many stages are there? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh my god, it actually goes back... it goes past 10. 20? 30? 40? 50? Wow, really? It goes up to... dude, it goes past 50. Wait, it only goes up to 66? Why 66? Why the random number? No, well, let's give that a try. Stage 66 of Asteroids, everybody, for the gaming of Retro Month. Ah, crap. Wait a second. Is it resetting my lives to only one now? Wait, so every single time, like, Oh, wait, nope. Now we're up to 2 lives. Yay. Wait a second. Am I changing that with the joystick, or what's happening? All right, well, anyways, Stage 66, let's do this thing. I don't know what to expect, although I have 4 lives again. And every single time I'm shooting these asteroids, they seem to be flying off like in random directions. A little bit. Whoa, holy crap. Why did it reset my score to 0? Wait a second, don't tell me that if you die it starts you back from the beginning, because that would mean that this is an infinite game. Oh yeah, and also apparently there's an actual story to this game. You're in some kind of asteroid belt, and you're fighting your way for survival. Let us enter the world of survival spaceships. Chris Redfield shooting boulders in space. Wow, listen to that beautiful, beautiful button mashing. Now, wait a second. Oh, I do not want you to... Oh, there we are. I couldn't even think of what I didn't want it to do. Yeah, geez, I really do apologize about, you know, my throat not being up to the challenge of commentating. But it is what it is, everyone. I'm sorry, and it's just the way of life and the way of suckage. Okay, I'm actually very surprised I'm doing this well. And this is the max level of the game. I'm trying to press the button more quietly. But I don't think that is very possible. No, don't thrust. Stay still. That is the best way to play this game I have found. And there we go. Oh, jeez. That could have killed me, you know? That brown thing looks like a mushroom. The one that's kind of gravitating towards me. And I know it's not really brown, it's orange, but whatever. Like, why are there so many different colors for these asteroids? I'm actually serious. Why are they, like, you know, orange and blue and green and stuff? What happened? Did, like, a rainbow planet explode or something? Did we just suddenly stumble into the pride belt of the asteroids? I don't know. Alright, come on. Die, space rocks! Chris Redfield demands it! Alright, let's see here. How can you commentate on this game? No, really, how can you? I don't know how you can. Oh, jeez. What? Alright, you know what? I'm very confused about how this thing resets whenever you die, so I'm gonna die again. What the hell does it like? Oh, wait a second. I think I know what it is. I think it's supposed to be a two-player game. Huh. Because, I mean, there are set lives for this one, and whenever I die, it ends up, you know, showing a different life count, so I think maybe this is supposed to be a two-player game. I'm over here playing with one player myself. And if I were to clone myself, that would be a bad idea. Ah, crap, I got an extra life. That means that this video is gonna last even longer. And I sort of don't want it to, because all it is just me in space shooting rocks. Color rocks! Like, how are you supposed to hand off the game to your friend that quickly, by the way? Because, I mean, look, whenever you die, because I'm gonna show this as an example, depending on if I can, there we go. Like, it just starts you off immediately. I mean, granted, the rocks, you know, they're nowhere near you at the time, but still. So, yeah, seeing as how I'm only doing this one player, I'm going to go be an hero. Follow your father's example, Fox! And smash into that boulder. So what, we got, like, Fox McCloud and Chris Redfield up in here? Shooting color rocks. This actually is not that bad for the very final difficulty of the game. Maybe it's just me. I don't know. How did that not hit me again? Well, that time it did, and I don't understand how it did. Oh well. No. Hey, he crashed. That's awesome. I think that was actually last life for that particular spaceship. I know that he had a wife and children, but it's okay. He's just a fictional video game character. Nah, you know what? Fine, I'm just gonna go straight forward shooting madly. Wow, look how fast I'm going, man. Yep. And I crashed right into that boulder upon shooting it. So whenever you hit down on the joystick over here, it teleports you randomly on the stage. I guarantee if I do it again, I'm going to die. Let's do it! Yeah, you see, it just sort of teleported me right in the middle of those asteroids. Color space rocks. I guess it's okay if you're, like, in a pinch. Like, you realize that you're about to die. and then you do it. But beyond that, I really don't see a point in doing it. Pew, 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 pew. You know what? Just from doing the whole entire pew, pew thing, I kind of want to go on a Star Wars marathon now. Maybe I'll do that after I record this. Seeing as how I don't really want to record anything else today. Just because my throat feels funny. I'm going to smash into you! That was kind of anticlimactic, don't you think? And you see that? My voice is kind of cracked. Anyways, everyone, this has been a showcase video. Probably the worst showcase video I'm ever going to do. Or at least the worst video for Asteroids that I'll ever do. This has been a showcase video of Asteroids. I don't know how you would actually commentate on the game itself, but there you go. So thanks for watching, and tune in tomorrow for yet another showcase video for Retro Gaming Month.